I'm going to show you how simple it is to make authentic guacamole using just a few ingredients. We start with ripe avocados, and an avocado is ripe when it's soft to touch. Not too soft, but soft enough that your hands sink in a little bit. And really and truly, there's no guarantee with an avocado that it's going to be good when you cut it open. It's so frustrating when you get them and they have the brown spots. For instance, this one's a little brown, okay? So I have a few backups just in case. Now, sometimes you can just peel the dark spots off, but always smell it, because if they've gone bad, they have a distinct smell. This one actually smells good, so I'm gonna cut some of those dark pieces off. But basically, you just take your knife, you go through the center like that, and then it splits right open. And this one is absolutely, that's perfect. That is exactly what I wanna see. So you cut those open and you scoop the filling onto a plate or into a bowl, because you're going to mash it. So this is organic guacamole. Juliet, come on. Now, I have 7 kids, so some of them happen to be here today, so I ask you to pardon any interruptions. Yeah, sometimes with avocados, you'll see some of those brown stringy pieces, and you just want to pull those off. This one does have a few. So we're going to just mash that, and it can be a little chunky if you like, or if you like it creamier, then you can mash it to a really creamy consistency. I like it a little bit on the chunkier side. All right. So that gets a quick mash, and then you take the juice of a lime. Okay, and the lime is actually what keeps it from turning dark. And don't ever fall for that line that avocados are fattening. They're actually good fat, and they contain what is called essential fatty acids that are so good for our bodies. Good for our skin, good for our overall health. All right, so I'm gonna put a couple grinds of fresh pepper, and the key to good guacamole, don't skimp on it, is good sea salt. I go for, if I'm using 2 avocados, I'm gonna put a whole teaspoon of salt. If you don't salt them enough, they're definitely gonna lack flavor. I've got some Frank's Red Hot, and you're gonna put about 2 to 3 dashes of that in there, depending on how much spice you like. And garlic. I've got 1 clove of garlic. Okay, and some red onions. You want to dice them as fine as possible. I would say about 2 tablespoons worth of finely diced red onion. Last, but certainly not least, fresh cilantro. I have my handy dandy herb grinder that I've already packed full of it, and you just twist it back and forth. If you don't have one of these gadgets, just chop it finely with a knife. And you're gonna put a good amount of that into your guacamole. That's how simple it is. Okay, I wanted to get a closer view here of the guacamole. So basically, once you have everything piled on there, you just mix it all around nice. And this is great just with chips or in tacos, burritos, nachos. It's pretty addictive, to tell you that. And there you have it. Simple, delicious, tasty, fresh, organic, vegan, vegetarian guacamole.